You alright, Chris and Gav here? And for the last time, Team Chav.
Yeah, end of an era, isn't
end
it?
End of an era. As I say, we're not going to touch it too much, but I think this is going to be the last video of Team Chav. So anyway, this is Doncaster pickups. And it could be a long one.
I'm drinking to get away from the blues of Team Chav.
No, come on, let's be happy though about it. Come on, let's celebrate. Like you're saying, this is going to be...
So what's our new name then, Chris?
Well, we're not saying yet. Till next week. You'll find out next week what our new name is.
I know. We've picked this it. Goes out. Are you putting this out on Wednesday?
This will probably be out Wednesday, so you'll find out in a few days' time.
Oh, if you're watching it on Saturday, just put our next one on and you can watch it then. You'll find out.
But we have picked a name. We know it is already. He's
whispering in the ear.
God, where's my head at tonight?
I'm not allowed to tell people because it's a no swearing channel.
Anyway, pick the new name. Up the find out next episode. Like I said, this is probably going to be a long video because Doncaster was a massive event. We've got quite a few pickups each. We met loads of people, so we have a lot to talk about.
You haven't got that many pickups like Chris.
Well, you are, haven't you? That's what I mean. We've got stuff to talk about, though.
Yeah. We can talk about
the stories behind a lot of the pickups.
All your free stuff.
Yeah, exactly. So I was saying there'll be a lot of waffling going on here. So let's just get into it. Like I said, we met up with Lee before I went in again, Retro Game Radix.
And we met Simon.
And also Simon Locke we met up with before we went into the event. It was just a nice shock, actually.
Went to McDonald's, didn't we?
Went to McDonald's, like you said. And I half recognised him. I walked round the window and no one, I looked through the window and it was a weird eye contact moment where we both recognised each other.
I was just walking around like this with my head down or something.
And I said to Gav, I said, I'm sure that's Simon Locke. And as I walked in, he kind of turned round when as if to give half a wave. And I said, we definitely know each other. So as I walked over, we kind of, you're right, Simon.
Doesn't show himself on camera as much, does he, Simon? Though?
No, not really.
He's more of a... sits in the background.
Yeah. No, but
not in a creepy way. Just like he comments a lot, doesn't he? And
he's always in the streams.
What's
and that. And
yeah, he's a moderator. Right.
He's actually a moderator in.
Yeah, I know. Him and everybody else.
Yeah, and him and everyone else.
I went away on Sunday and I came back and there was like six moderators and I'm thinking, what's going on here, like, Chris?
It's not six moderators, it was three. There was
three moderators. How many moderators do you need, like
Joe and the what level?
Does he get
Simon
that
Lock
and Simon Rock.
Lock. And the reason is, I'd ask us to be, for the same reason I probably have to ask you now, because you're looking all, why did you ask me?
I should have been the first moderator on that blooming channel. The amount of Zelda, I've had to put up with.
What channel are we on about, Oh, the Zelda Cricket channel, the other one. I tell you what, I'll leave the link in the description, why don't you just go and subscribe to it? Where I do live plays.
You don't have to,
plays every Sunday. I'm actually playing Breath of the Wild at the moment.
You don't have to.
But anyway, it was...
Classical. I wouldn't be subbed unless he was sat right here next to us.
Yeah, he was, it's awesome. Him and his wife, every Sunday night, jump and watch me play the Zelda games.
Yeah.
So there's two viewers right there.
To be fair, it is three because I put it on the telly. Because he won't put his chat on the screen. So you've got to have your phone and the telly, and then she's got her phone as well.
I would do it on my phone.
So he's got three subs out of two of us. Because my TV will be different.
Like a third view.
Yeah.
Well, I'm happy for it. Have you not got an iPad you can put on there?
No. Anyway. Went to Doncaster.
Back to Simon Locke. Like you say, it was...
Oh yeah, Simon, aye.
We had breakfast with him at McDonald's, got a bit of crack.
Yeah, well, you got yours, and then I was waiting for someone to come. And I was just in a daydream, when you're waiting for someone to come, and you just stood there thinking. And my tea came, so I went over to get some sugar or something. And all I heard was, I think he got that coat from a charity shop. And I thought, who's that? I turned around, and there's Russ and bloody... Big Daddy C stood behind us, talking about my bright green coat. It was like, yeah, I can't say what I said to them, mate. Again, not allowed to swear. Not that I do swear anyway. I'm family friendly.
Yeah.
But, Then we walked in.
Yeah, we went in. Like you say, we went with Sam Rover. We met Lee just outside.
We went. It was one of them awkward things, wasn't it? Because let's say he had to go back to his car, so we went in. And then he met up with Lee.
Yeah, we kind of departed.
Yeah.
And then he must have bumped into Lee, and then we kind of bumped into them two again, and we all went in together, didn't we?
Yeah.
And watch, we're in the event house, we went straight to... See, where we went in, we went straight over to...
Saw Tilty, didn't we?
Tilty straight away.
And,
Lewis.
I can't remember what his YouTube channel's called.
Wish Wash.
Wishy Washy.
Wishy Wash, something like that. I shall leave a link in the description below.
There's going to be a lot of links in the description.
There is, because we met a lot of people.
There's a guy called Tilty, UK as well. I'll leave a description in the link below.
But straight
or a link
away,
in the description.
Yeah, we did promise Tilty that we'd give him a shout out.
He needs all the support he can get.
Tilty UK, his channel. Yeah. I don't know if you've watched him before, but he just does a lot of pickups. He's a bit of a lizard, to be fair. Yeah, I think that shares in CEX, but I'll leave a link to his channel. So if you wouldn't mind just giving him a sub, he'll probably appreciate it if you want to sub.
If you go
onto
the CEX homepage, I think he's got a link in there somewhere.
We now take retro, and it's like a picture like that.
Picture too.
Well, anyway, as soon as we walked in, like, so I don't say Tilty, I got chatting to Lewis, and he asked if I had one of these, and I said no, which is the Majora's Mask figure.
What do you call him?
What, that?
Mm-hmm.
It's Majora's Mask.
Well, what's it? Who's the guy?
He's a Skull Kid.
What's his name?
Skull Kid.
Skull Kid wearing Majora's Mask?
Yeah.
Is that what he's actually called?
No, he's just a Skull Kid and he's got Majora's Mask on. It's the mask, what's like the bad.
Why don't you just say if you don't know his name?
I know this is his name. But anyway, he just, I got chatting to him and he says, hey, Chris, just have it. And I couldn't believe it. He had a price tag like £15 on. And like I said on the video, you're probably saying, oh, it's, they were good things and they come back. Because the first time I met Lewis was an event last year, and I had a bag full of trade like I normally do, and there was some Dreamcast games in. And he said he was after them, so I just let him have a look through, and he had to pick off 3 or 4 games out, and he offered his money. I says, oh, just keep it, man, I'm not bothered. Yeah. Do you mean now for me? What goes around will come back around one day. And it did. So to be fair, it wasn't really for free, because you could class it as a trade that took 6 months to do.
Well, you didn't want anything for games, did you?
So, like saying, go and check his channel out. He's only got a few subs at the moment, but he's got an awesome room to it.
I have to say, I think I'm in Tilty's pocket off what I got off him, mate. I felt shocking when I walked away from his stall.
Oh, you're about Tilty now?
Yeah.
I'm still about Lewis and his channel.
Yeah, but I'm saying I felt like I was in Tilty's pocket when I walked away.
Well, anyway, that's it. But check out Lewis's channel, because
we'll get back to that.
We'll get back to Tilty, because he needs all the shout-outs he can get.
Mm-hmm.
He's going for a full Wii U collection, Wish Wash, and he's getting close.
Wii U,
yeah.
What do you call him that's going for that? 007?
Herbie-ass.
Herbie-ass, 007.
Anyway, I've got nothing out.
Right.
And then we just had a wander around, didn't we?
Yeah, now I found this.
Yes, you did.
The first store.
Was that your first purchase?
It was, yeah. It was a big purchase as well. Which I didn't want to do, but...
I'm just going to put stuff in the water, Gav, so I know what I bought and when.
Right, well, the first thing I saw was...
Yeah, go on.
Something from your Mega Man collection. It's a boxed Mega Man 2 for the Game Boy. This is the American version, like, which kind of put us off. But the box is nice condition. It's got a bit of a dent in the back. And a bit of a bulge in the front, but I'm sure I can iron that out.
But for the price, the video was class. Obviously, when I watched it,
I haven't seen the video yet.
Yeah, I've seen it yet, but obviously I've said load. I've obviously been editing it, so
yeah.
But you pick the game up and like shut the camera, then you're putting it back down because it's like American.
Yeah,
and you're not bothered. You know, how much is that? And like literally your hand moves away and he goes like 25 and your hand's off it for like 3 seconds. Oh, 25. It's like the price is that good.
Yeah.
You weren't going to get it and all of a sudden he tells you the price and it's like, oh, and straight back up, you just pick it straight back up as if they think I'm having that.
Not a brilliant price, but it's a good price.
Oh yeah, it's a good price.
It is a good price. And then he had this, didn't he?
Yeah. which is this actually wasn't on camera, so this is exclusive.
Team Chav,
last video exclusive.
It's Mega CD, the second version, Mark II. Doesn't have the metal plate or the extension piece on the side. I don't know if you have to buy them separate. I would have thought it would have come in with this. And didn't have the speaker cable. I think that's what they are. I'm not sure where you plugged in.
There we go.
To your earphones and it comes into the back. So I've just bought one.
Nice.
Simon Locke was with us and he helped us out actually, because that was for 75? No, it wasn't 75, was it? No. 55,
yeah.
That was up for 55. And that was 25. And it came with two games. Yeah. Thunderhawk, no box. And Jaguar XJ220 or 220. Which I haven't played yet. I played Thunderhawk for a bit. It's not bad, it's a bit of daftness. But I've been after one of them for ages, like.
Yeah,
I've plugged it in and everything, and I've just got nowhere to put it on my shelves, so I'm going to have to rearrange. But I don't know how I can. I need to put another shelf in. Well, I've got two shelves there, I need to have another one in between.
Yeah, one in between.
But it's all glued and screwed together, and it's all made up into one solid unit. So, I don't know what I'm going to do. Yeah. Anyway.
I can't believe you picked one up, like, shop pickup of the day.
It was the very first store we went to. We walked down this aisle first, and on the very corner of the first aisle we walked down.
Like, first purchase.
Yeah, so it was this, like, and 55 quid, and that for 25 quid. And you, big mouth here, yeah, butting in.
Would you do 75?
I was like, shut up, Chris! Anyway.
Yeah.
And then he said, like, I'll do 75, and I was like, I'd rather have 70, like.
Yeah.
And he wasn't going for it. And I think I just loitered around his stall that much that he said, you've been standing around for a long time, have him for 70. Because yeah. Simon did it. He did say, well, he's going to have to buy a cable there, like 15 quid.
Yeah, like, the thing was, you said you weren't going to take it, and you said you were just going to take Mega Man.
Yeah.
And that's when he says, oh, I'll do it for 70.
Yeah. Well, I'm happy with that for 50 and 20, really, wasn't it?
Awesome pickup, and like saying, shock pickup of the day.
Yeah.
I just couldn't. See, he stood around that long, and I turned the camera off, and that's why it wasn't on the footage. So.
Sometimes you have to put the work in, though, don't you?
Yeah.
I put my puppy dog eyes on and everything, and then just started loitering outside, right in front of all, so all the customers couldn't get to him, and he had to give in eventually. Cost them more customers than it was worth.
Right, now was it me next, Gav? Possibly?
Probably.
Where do we go first? Do we get that or was it the Hunter?
The where?
No, I think this is the next one, wasn't it?
Yeah, probably.
I'll just talk about it anyway. And it was Link's Awakening DX.
That was your one regret, wasn't it?
Kind of. I mean, look at that. 60 quid on it. Why is it up? It's only 60 pound gear. And I still can believe it.
You still paid.
I paid 45, which I thought was an awesome price. I mean, I thought it's a £45 game. But it'd have been nicer if it was up for 45 and I go for 40.
That's probably why he priced it at 60. He was the bloke that says, am I going to be on YouTube?
Yeah. He'll be watching this because I know he's going to wait.
He'll be watching the last one to look for his face.
He'll be watching this one because he says he'll be sure his kids will be on about this or something. So, cracking day for 45, but why is it up for 60? I don't get. He had other Zelda games up for 30 and 35.
Yeah, that was the expensive one out of the lot, wasn't it?
I couldn't care, it's a tough variant, but I don't know if I knew that. So, I mean, it's...
He had loads of Game Boy games.
It's this one's a holograph. Holographic? Hologram? Yeah, it's not a hologram. So it is a harder one to find, but I don't think Hayden knew that.
Right. I don't know, he had plenty of Game Boy games, he thought he'd pick something up.
Look, I did pick that one up the week before. I can see that one there. So I've got them both now anyway.
Yeah, I thought you already had the hologram one.
Yeah, well that's it. And if you look at the footage, I'm trying to cut a deal and you say, have you already got that one, Chris? And I didn't want to say yes, but this is the one that I need because it's the hologram. Yeah. Because if he knew that I really needed it, you probably wouldn't have dropped. That's why I just kind of, if the footage, I just carry looking forward as if think, don't talk to us, Gav. Don't say anymore.
It's exactly the same, apart from that hole. Oh, no,
it's got a different thing on the side.
It hasn't got a thing on the bottom there on the side. The bottom's different as well.
Yeah, is that a different opening?
Yeah, that's got the thing there with the two triangles, and that hasn't. That's just like the top type of opening. Mm. Yeah,
interesting.
Apart from that, it's exactly the same though. Oh, and this one's got a pre-owned sticker on the barcode where that one hasn't. There you are.
Loads of difference.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Bit more useless information for you. For all you aspiring Zelda collectors.
Makes it all worthwhile now, doesn't it? Makes it all worthwhile.
Yeah. Mind you, the 60 quid one is in better nick than the 45 or whatever you paid for it. 40. 30.
I don't know, in my head, I'm thinking about 40 quid for Game Boy games, like. If it was minty, 60 quid,
I'm thinking more like 20 quid for Game Boy games, at most.
Yeah. But, like you're saying, I thought 45 was a decent price. But to be fair, it's probably one of the best knockdowns, 15 quid knocked off that one game.
That's probably because he overpriced it by like 15 quid.
But he was actually spot on,
fella. He was a really nice guy.
We had loads of crack with him. I'm not begrudging price, that's what he wants to sell for, that's what he wants to sell it for.
It's up to him. His stuff, he can sell for whatever he wants.
He had loads of good stuff. Now, I mean, some of his other games were reasonably priced, the old ones. They were like 35s and that.
You've just already got them.
Yeah, I've already got them. And like you said, he was actually a really nice guy. I can't remember his name. I don't know if I even got his name. But I'll have to keep an eye open for next events because, he had loads of good stuff in.
I tell you, I couldn't even remember what he looked like right about now.
Yeah, well, I know what he looked like, so I've seen his face loads in the video.
Yeah. me next, is it?
Yeah.
I think you pretty much got everything for a good long time, like, to be fair, but... Soul Funk Retro Store, we went and had a bit of crack with him.
Yeah.
When I'm back on camera. Hello. Yeah, we were talking to Soul Funk for a bit, and... Bubba Block was ran off his feet, like, wasn't he?
He was, like...
He had Russ helping him. Yeah. Helping them is like a
which
bit
means
of a stretch.
Russ was in the bar.
Paul
was run off.
Paul actually did try to help him.
Yeah, I think Paul was getting a bit angry at Russ. Where's he at now? He's back in the bar.
I think half of Paul trying to get to help Matt was by trying to find Russ to come back to the stall type thing, you know. But I was talking to Matt for a bit, and then like he was ran off his feet talking to customers and telling them, I can get your prints, this, that, and the other type thing. Ask what you want and all that. And I just looked on the stall next to us and saw this. And I was looking at it on eBay before and I thought, I wouldn't mind that, but I'm not paying like 20 plus quid for it or whatever it was going for. I can't really remember. It was a while ago. But they had this for 12. It's The Adventures of Mighty Max, the cartoon series back in the day. I used to love it. Like, played the game, it's horrible. The game is absolute horrible. Like.
Is it?
Yeah. It could be alright if you put some time into it, but...
I can't remember that, I remember the little...
The chicken that talks.
Yeah.
I used to like the big meathead who liked his sword. He lost his sword one episode and all the way through was saying, I want my sword. He gets it at the end and goes to stab someone and then all of a sudden he just takes it away and chucks him down the pit. Ah, fond memories. Tenner, paid for it. Knocked 2 quid off. Like you say, we like dealing in pound notes, don't we?
We do.
Fives and tens and stuff. So, yeah, £10, stall next to Matt. Christopher?
What? The Hunter?
He was one of the early ones we went to.
Yeah.
Because the week before we saw him at Leeds, didn't we?
Yeah, the week before we saw him at Leeds, we had a good crack.
He was going around asking for this item with all the stars, and one of them had it for like 8 quid or something, didn't he?
He had it for 8.
And you were like, is that a good price? I'm like, you want a fiver for that?
Yeah,
it's worth a fiver all day long. It's not worth it, like, really.
He wouldn't knock down Doncaster, would he? So I said, I'll
leave it. He wouldn't knock it down.
But anyway, so I mentioned the Retro Hunter that I was after one, and he said he'd bring one for us to Doncaster.
Have you tested it yet, like?
Yeah, right.
Works.
Yeah.
All
right. And the someone's walked up, I hadn't even spoken to him, so he's just waiting at the door, here, got this for you, and lifted up. And there it is, light phaser for the mass system.
You forgot all about it, didn't you?
Yeah, and he just walked on, he says, yeah, I've got this for you. And I said straight away, oh, how much you want for it? He says, oh, just keep it. He says, it's untested. He says, cause it was the last thing he packed, he says, he was, he's car was packed in, I just remembered, oh, I asked for a gun, and he chucked it in, it's untested, so I just take it. And like I said, unbelievable, just another free gift.
Yeah, spot on, like, wasn't
it? It was, absolutely spot on. So thank you very much, mate, for that.
Yeah, and then you felt obliged to buy something, didn't you?
Yeah, while we were there, I picked up Fantasy Zone on my system.
Yeah, you were like, oh, I'm going to have to pay full price. I said, here, give us a D. I was going to get it. I was going to get this. Castlevania, Super Castlevania on the Super NES. No instructions, but boxed. Box isn't in too bad condition. It's got a flap missing on the top there. But it's nice and square. Yeah. Bit of sellotape. I don't know what it is about me and buying boxes with sellotape on, but it's got a bit of sellotape wrapped around there. I mean, I've cleaned it and you can hardly see it now. It's fading away. I think actually it's come off. So when that dries up as much as it's going to dry, I'm just going to let it flake off and then clean where it was, and it'll be hopefully as good as new.
As good as new.
Yeah, no instructions, like I say, and that was up for 50. Well, you can pay 45 for the car alone, you know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It was a really good price, wasn't it?
So I said, give us your game here and I'll see what he'll do. And he knocked a fiver off. And I shouldn't have done it, really, like. I would have been able to get a fiver off that alone, like.
Yeah.
But him being him, he put his puppy dog eyes on and I just said, pass it.
Well, it's the first of me fantasy. I want all three, so yeah. I've been saying for a while I may want them now. So, can you believe it? It's not Zelda.
Yeah, no, is that the first of your non-Zelda pickups, or is that the only non-Zelda pickup?
I might have one more.
So yeah, 50 quid, no, 47.50 for that. Thank you, Retro Hunter.
Yeah.
I wouldn't care, you know. I took the cart out and the back of the cart was like yellow one, and I got, do you remember Kirby's Ghost Trap?
Yeah.
Well, that had a good back on it, and I'm not bothered about that game at all. So I swapped the back was exactly the same as the back of this one. Swapped them over, cleaned it all up and everything, like the front couple of little grubby marks on, and I cleaned all the contacts like while it was out, because I bought some tech screwdrivers, because if I'm buying expensive games I want to make sure they're legitimate, you know. Took it all apart, cleaned it all up and everything, put the nice back on, put it in the Super NES, turned it on, not working, turned it off. Took it out, put it back in, turned it on, not working, turned it off. Did it for about maybe 20 minutes, thinking, oh, I don't, it's just, he would honour it, you know, he would like, oh, send it through and give you money. But it was like the fact that it's a hassle to start with, plus I'd cleaned it all up, so he might look at it and say, well, that's a different one, that. You know, he might have really. Because who cleans the cartridges before they try them, you know?
Yeah. I was just thinking that. So there's no doubt ago, did not work before.
Wait, no, that's the thing. And it was like, oh, God, I can't believe it. I turned it on and just left it, and it's a slow start. Oh, it takes about 10 seconds for the logo to come up on the screen. And I was like, oh, thank you, God. I couldn't believe it, like. But no, it just shows a black screen, and then like about 5 to 10 seconds later, it comes across with the logo on the top. I thought, oh.
So it was working all the time.
Possibly, possibly, yeah. But it was a nice little twist. I was wounded like when it wasn't working. I thought, oh man, he's, you know, I wouldn't do it, but I'm sure that you do get people who do that, buy, have a game that doesn't work, so they'll buy one, offer a company, and then take it back saying it doesn't work.
Yeah.
You know? Or just a tacky cart or something like that, you know, like a damaged label, buy it off eBay and say it's not very good condition, like described, and get the money back, keep the cart probably as well. Yeah. So that was the Retro Hunter.
Yeah. What next? Have you got any more before?
Yeah, just random pickups. Got this off a random guy selling bits and pieces, £5. Didn't ask for anything off because it's only £5, you know. Can't ask for no offer fiver. It's a Wii game, Dragon Quest, Swords. I didn't think fiver was a bad price for a Dragon Quest game. turns out it's about right. I looked inside. It's got instructions and everything, but the disc, a few light scratches.
Yeah, I think you're humming out a little bit about that.
Yeah, I was looking on your store for about 10 minutes trying to find something to bundle in and get some money off you now. And the disc, it's very faint light scratches, but there's a lot of them, you know. And saw it on another stall a couple of minutes later, like straight down the aisle for exactly the same price, and I thought, typical in this. But yeah, fiver, it is what it is. And I'll show this.
Yeah,
I got this one, and I just went up and bought it. I think they had two copies, one with instructions, one without instructions, both for £7. Silent Hill 2. It was getting towards the end of the day and I just wasn't thinking. It had a plastic cover on, you know, so I didn't take it out and look at it or not. Just read with instructions, same price as the other. And I mean, there's the instructions there. And it's got a big mark there where someone took a sticker off. Thank you very much. This is all when I got home. I looked at this. Looked at the discs. Someone's peeled the sticker off there. Don't know if you can see that right there. Bit of damage on that disc. Someone's peeled the sticker off that disc. Bit of damage on that disc right on the face there. You see it? So, no cover.
Yeah.
Two discs damaged. I would imagine they work. It's just the picture that's damaged on them. I haven't tested them yet. You live and learn, don't you?
Yeah.
That's the thing. When the I mean, the cover that it was in, it's one of them tight ones that's awkward to get on and off. If it was 20 quid or something like that, you'd probably check. Seven, fiver. I think I got it for a fiver or six, maybe. You tend not to. It's not worth the hassle, is it?
No,
taking it out and putting it back in and everything, so live and learn.